Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 14 GM, or Golden Master. This is the final version that will release to the public as soon as tomorrow. Apple announced today that they're releasing iOS 14, iPadOS 14, tvOS 14, and watchOS 7 tomorrow on 9/16, or September 16th, 2020. And so this is the version that's finalized. So if you're a developer or a public beta tester and you have iOS 14 GM on your device, it will just say iOS 14. You'll be able to have the final version just one day early, and then we'll have it to all of the other people on iOS 13 tomorrow. So that's pretty quick. I haven't seen Apple do that before, and this came in at a very large 4.79 gigabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. So let's see if there's anything new compared to Beta 8, and talk about what to expect tomorrow. Now, once you've installed iOS 14 GM, you're probably wondering, how do I get off of the beta program? And if you're not familiar with that, all you do is uninstall the beta profile. So you go to your settings, go down to general, then scroll down to the bottom. You'll see profile, tap on profile, remove it, put in your passcode, hit remove again, restart your device. Once you're rebooted, you have the final version. You just had it a day early. So that's all you have to do. You'll stop receiving beta updates and you'll have the final version. And when the next public update comes out, you'll be able to install that. Now, this particular update, let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So if we go to general and about, you can see this build is 18A373. So compared to iOS 14 beta 8, which was 18A5373A, this is essentially the exact same build. They just removed all of the debugging stuff that goes on in the background for developers, as well as feedback. And so if you were having issues with this particular update, you're going to continue to have issues if you were on beta 8. Now, the good thing is beta 8 was pretty stable, but that means you have no new modem update in this particular update. Now, one of the first questions I get asked after installing an update is there new wallpaper? So if we go to settings, scroll down to wallpaper, go to choose a new wallpaper, we go to dynamic. I don't really see anything new there. Stills, there's nothing new there. And live. So you do have live wallpaper with night and day or night and dark, but nothing particularly new or exciting. So unfortunately, there's not a ton of new wallpaper, and I wouldn't expect them tomorrow as well. And that's really it. So beta 8, they felt was stable enough to release it to the public, basically. And there are still some known issues in this one. For example, there's 22 known issues, mostly for developers, but a few widget problems that you may experience from time to time. And then there's one resolved issue for developers. But apps such as Pokemon Go still will not work. That will need an update. And you'll probably see that update tomorrow to fix that issue. So you'll see a ton of different app updates starting tomorrow after you receive iOS 14, or if you're already on it, you'll just see a ton of different app updates. You'll see this number will go into the 40s, 50s, sometimes hundreds if you have a lot of apps. And so the overall performance of Beta 8 and GM should be very similar as well, although Geekbench tests seem to be a little bit better, and we'll talk about that in a moment. So overall, this particular build is great, not only on iPhone, but on older iPhones. So if you're going to come in from, say, an iPhone 6S Plus like this one, expect performance to be decent. You shouldn't have any issues. You'll see it says what's new in Apple Music. You're going to see a bunch of these things pop up. We'll wait for it here. And you'll see just switching. In fact, you'll probably see better performance than you did with iOS 13 or the same. So don't expect a degradation in performance. Expect games like Minecraft or Pokemon Go or Call of Duty Mobile, any of those to function as you would expect. And the same is true on the new modern hardware, of course, such as iPhone 11. Expect the same sort of fast, fluid experience. iOS 13 was full of bugs, and they've fixed most of those major bugs by now and carried that over to iOS 14, where it's better, and iPadOS 14. So iPadOS 14, again, fast and fluid. I've had no issues with it, and it's just been super fast. In fact, with beta 8, I really had no issues. A couple little lockups, but that probably needs some app updates from Twitter, for example. So I did have a few issues from Twitter. Now, if this is in fact the exact same as beta 8, that means that battery life should be about the same. Without the background debugging working, you may get a little bit extra battery life. So if we go into settings, and then we'll go back to battery, And we'll take a look at the battery health. You'll see I'm at 96%. And like I said before, this does not degrade based on updates, but rather when you update, it just checks the actual battery health overall. And so don't expect it to go down, or it's just rechecking it. Now, if we take a look at yesterday or maybe the day before, you'll see my screen on time is not that great, but today I've had 3 hours and 35 minutes of screen on time, 7 hours and 11 minutes of screen off time playing music and things like that. And so if we bring that out, that was about 50% usage, double that, we're getting 7 hours of screen on time, but 14 hours of screen off time. Now, if I wasn't playing things in the background, of course, this would improve. And of course, as apps get updated, this will improve as well. I would expect iOS 14 GM to improve this additionally, just based off of the overall experience with when you go from a beta to a final version. That's why it was a huge version going from beta to the final, from final to beta. Any of those, you're going to see a huge file size. Now, this particular beta, like I said, is fast and fluid, but nothing really new with the GM. So it looks like that's what the final version is going to have. And then we'll probably see an iOS 14.1, maybe when iPhone 12 launches, or maybe before. It's really hard to say at this point. Now, the good thing is benchmarks in general seem to be okay. Now, I did run it twice, and a couple things to note here is it may be a little bit low because I ran it right after installing the update. So I scored 1,331 for single core, only 3,224 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, you'll see I did have faster multi-core last week. I would expect this to improve greatly after it finishes doing whatever it's doing in the background, indexing and finishing some tasks as well. Now let's take a look at these devices here that I have, the 6S Plus 11 and iPad Pro. Now I have the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020 on the left, followed by the iPhone 6S Plus, followed by the iPhone 11, and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And they seem to be performing pretty good at this point. Give them a few more hours, they'll probably get much better. In fact, some other people are saying it's performing the same as iOS 13.5.1 as far as Geekbench scores are concerned. So tomorrow, expect not only iOS 14, iPadOS, but watchOS 7, and a lot of exciting updates coming out, and then we'll see even more in the coming weeks. So I really look forward to that. So that's it for iOS 14 GM. Of course, I'll have a public release video tomorrow once it comes out. And let me know what you think of iOS 14 GM in the short day that you'll get to use it if you're a developer public beta tester. And of course, I'll be doing a follow-up later this week or on Sunday like I normally do. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.